Hi guys, Nathan Middle down under here. I thought I'd enter Middle Mickey's 500 subscribers contest. Very well deserved. He actually deserves a lot more than 500 subs. Absolutely amazing guy. Killer collection. So friendly to talk to. Really, really funny. Loves wearing his dressing gown in his videos. And just a brilliant guy. I crack up most of his videos. And I haven't missed one. I've watched all of his videos that he brings out. And it's really, really killer stuff. He had 5 questions to answer, and I thought I'd give it a go. I thought I might struggle with a couple of them, but here we go. The first question was, what band do you think would have been bigger than they actually were? And I thought long and hard about it, and I came up with the band Overdose, which I just recently showed in one of my update videos. Absolutely love Overdose. They're a Brazilian speed metal, thrash metal band. But I just think that they're in the wrong place at the wrong time. They came out basically the same time as Sepultura came out. I love Sepultura as well, and Sepultura just blew up big time and left Overdose in the dust. I'm not sure how big they were in Brazil, but elsewhere they're unknown. But I actually prefer Overdose to Sepultura. Absolutely love their stuff. So that's my first answer, has been Overdose. Killer stuff. The next question was, what band do you think were bigger than they should have been? And for me, that's a very easy question to answer. Actually, I don't own anything by the band. The band is Nirvana. I enjoyed Smells Like Teen Spirit and most of the Nevermind album, but I didn't think they'd get the success that they actually deserved. I don't think they actually deserved the success. Kurt Cobain was just a knob, just a bell end, really. And back in that day, I was into my glam metal and hard rock, and a lot of my favourite bands when the grunge era came in started tending towards a bit more grunginess in the sound, which I just didn't get into. So yes, my answer to that is Nirvana, because I don't have anything by them, and I don't think I ever will get anything by them. Don't absolutely hate them, but not one of my favourite bands in the world. So the answer to that one is Nirvana. Third question is, what album holds the happiest memories for you? That was also an easy one for me, and that was Def Leppard's Hysteria. This was actually the first album that I ever owned, and it actually, from this album, actually led me on my hard rock and heavy metal journey. I heard a few songs beforehand by other bands, Twisted Sister, Kiss, but it wasn't until I owned my own copy of Def Leppard's Hysteria that I decided that's my kind of music. I remember listening to this in my bedroom constantly, non-stop. Friends came around too and we all listened to it. Loved every single song on the record. And just last year, as a lot of you know, I went to the 30th anniversary Def Leppard of show of the Hysteria. Absolutely wrapped with gone to that. So that's my answer. Happiest moment, the happiest memories would be Def Leppard and Hysteria. Great stuff. And the fourth question, an album that you have not heard all the way through. I've actually got quite a few, but I picked this one here, and that is Sepultura's Nation. I have probably listened to, I may have listened to the whole album, but it was just in the background and I didn't really pay any attention to it. And after that point, I did listen to a few of the songs, but I stopped halfway through, so I actually don't remember any songs. This album was from 2001, with a later singer. I did much prefer the Max Cavalera and Igor days of the band, But this is the album Nation by Sepultura that I haven't listened to all the way through. Here we go. And this question, the last question was, name and show an album with a dog on the cover. And I thought I'd really struggle with this, and I was looking through my collection and I was pleasantly surprised I actually found two to show. So I'll show them now. The first one, take it out of the sleeve, is the band Danger Danger. And you might not be able to see, but down the bottom here, there's a lady walking three dogs. So that's basically my honourable mention because it's very, very small. The main one I'm going to show is a pop rock band, a bit of punk going on there. It's a band by the name of Hawk Nelson. And there we go. Little pug dog in there with the glasses, which I've actually forgotten I owned. And I forgot what the cover looked like anyway. So that's Hawk Nelson. So pretty surprised to find that. So once again, Mike, congratulations on your 500 subs. I'm sure you'll get plenty more in the future, and look forward to hearing more responses to your contest. So cheers for now. Bye.